Welcome to Getting Better Daily. Don't forget to like this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos. The 7 phrases you should never say to anyone. If there was ever a time to take hard steps to make difficult conversations easier on both parties, this will be it. To get you started, below are 7 of the phrases recommended not saying to anyone. Number 1. Come here. Imagine you are sitting at your desk and your boss steps out from their office and says, "Come here," to you in front of your co-workers. If you are anything like me, no matter how high you are holding your head prior to hearing this word, you pretty feel small. Ordering someone to come over to you may make you feel like you have authority, but when it comes to having people respect you, phrases like "come here" have the opposite effect, as even kids don't want to be spoken to like they are a child. When people hear the words "come here," their first instinct is to turn around and run, as if it's a massive signpost they are in trouble. Remember this the next time you have the urge to say "come here" to anyone. Remind yourself that you don't like to hear these words, and the odds increase tremendously that you are not the only person who feels this way. Saying in a calm voice, "Would you mind if we chatted for a moment?" or simply, "May I talk to you?" is much more effective, as it gives people the freedom to make their own decisions. And if people want anything, it's the choice to act on their own free will. Number 2. Because those are the rules. 5 truths that apply to all people, no matter their age, culture, or race. All people want to be treated with dignity and respect. All people want to be asked rather than told to do something. All people want to be informed as to why they are being asked or ordered to do something. All people want to be given choices rather than threats. All people want a second chance when they make a mistake. The words "because those are the rules" don't directly hit all these 5 truths, but they do touch upon most of them. They show a lack of respect. They do not give people a choice. They are not informative. A good rule of thumb is that if you are about to say something and it goes against any of these 5 truths, let alone 3, it's best not to say them. "Because those are the rules," or "the super annoying because I said so," makes you sound weak, and it shows you do not have the knowledge to support your order with logical reasoning. On the flip side, by explaining why something is the way it is, you offer people a neutral piece of ground for them to stand on while opening a door for them to save face if they don't end up complying with your explanations. In short, if you are going to give people anything, let it be your why. And if you don't know the answer, find out. Number 3. Calm down. Rarely is your first response the best response. That being said, no matter how many times I remind myself of this and try to remove the words "calm down" from my vocabulary, I still let those words slip from time to time. Instead of helping us to reach the desired outcome of getting someone to slow their rolls, the word "calm down" makes people feel like you are criticizing their behavior and suggests that their reason for being upset are invalid. Not only that, but like many of the phrases on this list, it makes people feel like they have to defend their actions. The next time you feel the urge to say "calm down" to either your kids or anyone else for that matter, try this instead. "It's going to be alright," "talk to me," "what's the matter," or simply "what's the matter." These phrases are not only much softer, but they serve as a signal that you want to better understand what the person you are speaking to with is going through and open to talking things out. Number 4. "I am not going to say this again." Besides making people feel threatened, this phrase is especially useless because it's almost always a lie, as most people say it over and over again in their arguments. When it comes to communication during this tense situation, repetition shows weakness. Depending on the situation, sometimes we have to stress our words and take a firm stand. Instead of saying, "I'm not going to say this again," try saying in a calm voice, "Listen, it's important that you get this point, so pay close attention to what I'm about to tell you." It too may sound strong, but it's not threatening. One other technique is to list out what you want the person to do and encourage them to be willing to think over it. The words "is there anything I could say that will get you to do A, B, C? I would like to think so" can be extremely persuasive, as they imply that the person you are speaking to with is indeed someone who is willing to calm down and have a civil conversation. Number 5. "What do you want me to do about it?" Take this moment right now and say these words, "What do you want me to do about it?" in a variety of tones. No matter how you say it, it sounds sarcastic, right? If there was ever an opposite of a problem-solving response, "what do you want me to do about it?" will be it. By saying this phrase, you now have 2 problems, the one you began with and the one you have just started by appearing to duck responsibility. So instead of saying the words, "what do you want me to do about it?" take the hard step of thinking creatively to help the person solve the problem they are facing, or point the person in the direction of someone who can better help if the problem they are facing isn't in your wheelhouse. If neither of these options is available to you, offer an apology and, "I'm sorry, I really do not know what to recommend, but I wish I did. I would like to help you," goes a long way in re-establishing trust while taking some of the heat out of the stressful conversation. Number 6. What's your problem? Have you ever had a productive, civilized conversation after someone says the words, "What's your problem?" Again, if you don't like to be on the receiving end of other phrases, don't say them to other people. The glaring problem with phrases like "what's your problem" is they put problem immediately back into the person who is in need of assistance. Not only that, it signals that this is a you versus me battle rather than an us discussion, which can only escalate the temperature of an already hot situation. No one likes to admit we have a problem or we are a problem. It makes us feel helpless and that we are a failure. So instead of going straight at someone like they are doing something wrong, choose to pad your language. This is where the question, "what's the matter?" can come in handy again, or simply, "how can I help you?" Number 7. Why don't you be reasonable? Have you ever suddenly become more reasonable when someone tells you to act more reasonably? If you are anything like me, your answer is a resounding no. Much like the words "calm down," the question, "why don't you be reasonable?" implies someone is acting out of line and has more potential to only add fuel to an already hot fire. Instead of having your words put people immediately on the defensive, first choosing your words of reassurance, then phrasing what the perceived problem is of the person in front of you. The words, "let me see if I understand your position," or "you are feeling X because of Y, is that correct?" are worth their weight in gold. This switch not only lets the person know you are working to better listen and understand them, but also gives them opportunity to clarify their stance so that you can get to the true heart of their concerns. Tying it up together, the theme that runs consistently throughout the recommendation is that empathy is the key to all successful human interactions. Empathy absorbs tension, and if you take the time not only to listen to people, but to work hard to see them in the way they see themselves, you can turn any negative situation into a positive outcome. Our world holds power, both good and evil. If you want to improve your relationship, few exercises are more valuable than keeping track of the words that lift people up while working to do away with the words that bring people down. Thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel for more awesome videos like this. Turn on the post notification to get notified anytime we drop a new video. Keep getting better and have a nice day.